You may have seen Brompton folding competitions on YouTube. It's amazing to see the winners aim to break the 5-second fold record. On the other hand, if you don't know what you're doing, you could fold it all wrong and end up damaging the bike. Ghent University in Belgium selected 20 people who had never seen a Brompton or a Dahon and asked them to fold a bike with no instructions or help. Only 3 out of the 20 succeeded in folding the Brompton correctly, and 6 for the Dahon. Those who accomplished the fold took an average of 105 seconds for a Brompton and 96 seconds for the Dahon. Unfolding the Brompton took longer than folding it. Once the group was shown the proper procedure, they were able to fold both types of bike in 37 seconds. In another study, researchers at the Korea Institute of Industrial Technology evaluated the foldability of different bicycle mechanisms. They measured 4 factors: folding and unfolding time, upper body flexion, ground reaction force, which measured the subject's effort while lifting the bike, and total hand movement. 10 volunteers with no previous experience with folding bikes were shown how to fold and unfold different types of bicycle. Testers wore a motion capture suit. 8 infrared cameras recorded folding and unfolding movements. A force plate sensor was positioned under each tester. They tested 4 different types of mechanism: mid-fold, or single vertical pivot, as used on the Dahon Curve D3 or the K3 Plus; single lateral pivot, as used on the Amico SPF 1500 or the Dahon Quix D3; combined vertical and lateral pivot, used by the Brompton; and dual lateral pivot, used on the Birdie. In this study, the Quix proved to be slightly faster to manipulate. The Birdie was the slowest to fold, taking 50% more time than the Dahon or the Brompton. As in the Belgian study, Brompton was the only bicycle to take more time to unfold than to fold. Trunk flexion was similar for the Dahon, Birdie, and Brompton, as users need to bend over to lift the bike off the ground. Ground reaction force measurements are correlated to the weight of the bicycle, with the exception of the Quix, which doesn't need to be totally raised off the ground. The Birdie required the most hand movement, which correlates with its slow folding time. When the results were compiled, bikes with lateral pivot mechanism were identified as the most convenient to fold and unfold. While we cannot easily modify the mechanism of a bike we already own, we can improve our folding time with practice. Most of us should be able to achieve 15 seconds or less, regardless of which type of folding bicycle we use. The introduction of lighter versions of Brompton, like the P or T line, can also reduce trunk flexion and ground reaction force while folding and unfolding, making these great choices for multimodal commuting. Finally, although not emphasized in the study, the bicycle folded size has a significant impact on its usability as part of multimodal transport. In that respect, the Brompton is still the one to beat. Of course, ease of folding is not the only parameter to look at when choosing a bicycle. If you want to know more about the differences between Brompton, Birdie, and Dahon, have a look at these 2 popular videos. And share your fast folding stories below. We're Pam and Gilbert from Two Bikes for Adventure.